Starting from this video diary entry, I think I will slightly change I will slightly change the some the type of point that I want to get across. I will try to capture some thoughts on how to attack hard problems from my own personal experience. I want to eventually write a paper about these things. All these kinds of things. I want to eventually write something about. So I will try to. It will not be extremely coherent, and unless you had like experience with this, it might seem somewhat strange. But I will try to keep it accessible. So my experiences with mathematical problems, but so it generalizes. So the most important point to think about now is. What is a hard problem and what is a hard mathematical problem? So usually there's a, I try to, so there's a very big difference between big problems which usually relate to humans and mathematical problems. The very big difference is that the mathematical problems, so there is a very big similarity, right? So mathematics can explain a lot of things about the world. For example, the director of the Institute of Advanced Study, a Dutch guy, I don't remember his name, he's very cool. He has a he has given a very good lecture on how math is important in physics and how mathematical thought, pure mathematical thought, eventually finds applications in physics, and he's not the only one to talk about this, of course. So, human problems like social problems, etc., of conflict and cooperation. So, these things they are related. So human situations like relationships, etc. Human situations can be approached in a mathematical way. Not necessarily. So not the mathematics we know necessarily, because the mathematics we know are kind of much more limited than relationships. However, the approach makes sense. I will talk about this. I will make a forward reference. So strategy makes sense in relationships. So basically, human problems and mathematical problems have important similarities, but there is a huge difference. So please pay attention. The huge difference. I just thought about it and I feel happy. So the huge difference is that mathematical problems do not have memory and they do not think about you. So for example, so suppose that you want to flirt with a girl and you say something very nice and you feel happy about it, etc. And then you're not very creative in the relationship. And so, but she will remember, for example, that you said something nice, it will stick with her, and her perspective changes. In mathematical problems, this is not the case. The problem will not remember you. So basically, in order to solve a hard mathematical problem, the important, so most, many scientists, I would want to say the vast majority, there are some exceptions. I think Newton was an exception like that. They have like some very good idea. So some ideas like don't work very much, but they have like a very brilliant idea, and they are so happy. And so they do the math, the analysis, etc., and it works. And so they are happy. And so if you want to solve a hard mathematical problem, forget about this completely. You need a constant pounding with extremely great ideas as they feel to you, initially at least. So feeling happy that you had a very nice idea and kind of works or works, etc., is forget about it. So, this is one important point I want to make. The other important point I want to make is like brain expansion. The brain is not limited, I think. As long as you challenge it, it will proceed. But you have to do it carefully, of course. You don't want to burn out or to go beyond what you can, because the brain adjusts not in a fashion that we are aware of necessarily, precisely. So you have to understand your brain. You are not your brain. Your brain is a tool. A consciousness, a thought, is something that is related to your mental modules, but it does not amount to them. Maybe at some level of abstraction, we will find out that there is a very deeper relationship there, but for the type of analysis I am referring to, the current status of mathematics, it is not possible to. It is not possible. It is not the case that the mental modules amount to you. You are not your brain modules. So the brain expands. So I am trying to crystallize the process. I have not crystallized it well yet. And the other thing is be honest with yourself what you want to solve. But don't necessarily be honest with others. So it has helped me a lot to kind of lie with others, because you want to have a good control over your problem. You don't care about the other's opinion necessarily. So Newton, in a very nice YouTube video I had watched, so someone was doing a narrative about Newton. So he was at a conference, and in casual conversation, he mentioned to someone that if there are forces and they obey inverse square laws, then you explain the planets, the ellipses of the planets, according to Kepler, the ellipses thing was. And so here the other person said, "How do you know that?" And Newton said, "I have proven it." And the other person said, "Okay, give me the proof." And he responded 2 years later with the Principia. So he hadn't proven it, but he saw it. So it's okay to lie with others, but do it in, not lie arbitrarily. If you are confident on how you, in your relationship with the problem, so the problem is also a relationship, right? It's not human relationship, but it's a relationship you have with the problem. It's okay to lie, to lie, it's like a sort of a white lie. So the important thing is to solve it. Not necessarily how you approach your relationship with others for your problem is something you should pay careful attention to. But you don't need to say that, okay. So you have to manage your relationship with a problem and how you talk about this with others. But that's an important thing. And I wanted to talk about strategy. So I think so I think so I used to write a lot on Facebook. I used to write a lot on Facebook. I will go back there at some point. So I wasn't sure whether Facebook was a good thing. But I think that Zuckerberg's intentions are very honest. So it was a very difficult experiment. And there are many ways by which it could have become or still can become problematic. But at least there is effort to do something good there. But right now it's not helpful for me to go back on Facebook. At some point I plan to consider the possibility of going back. So I had written a post on Facebook that basically the post was essentially saying that I understand God's strategy in creating the universe. I believe that if you actually believe that, it makes sense to actually. So every time there is a scientist that discovers something new and important, so there is this romantic thing to say, okay, so after that, it's God. Because so this is ridiculous, I think. I'm not sure if there is God or if there is no God, and what is God and what is not. What I care about is the mental representation of the world. So if you have to compete with God to solve a hard problem, you use the Hattori Hanzo approach and you create a sword that cuts God's on the way. So it's a, I don't, this is not disrespectful against God, because you don't know. Even if you believe there is God, etc., you don't know. Okay, you don't know. So you don't have to constrain yourself. And I have to tell you that as long as you push your brain properly, it expands. So don't worry about your limitations. Of course, you have to be respectful to yourself. But I think there are no limits to the brain. So there was a very nice thing, a video I was watching on YouTube, that the brain structure is more complex than the universe. So this is not a joke. So if you think that your brain can capture the universe, so basically that video was very helpful, because it says, if my brain structure is more complex than the universe, all you have to do is exploit it. But in a very respectful way to your brain. So it will help you as well. So yes, so I will try to capture in some videos, diaries, my diary entries, my thinking there, and my goal is to write a paper about this at some point. But I also need to crystallize some things, and these recordings, these diary entries, I hope to help me in this direction, and hopefully, either now or maybe later in the future, others as well. So the important thing to capture is that there is some progress here. Can you see here? So let me continue. So I would like to ju just juxtapose two approaches toward one hand problems. Mathematical problems, and the other hand relationships. So in either case, you can have a functional approach with respect to mathematical problems and relationships. So the functional approach in relationship is to be like Drogo against Daenerys. See, you are my functional wife, and you will satisfy my sexual hard-ons. I think many people have to that actually. The functional approach in mathematical problems is to take a result, let's say in theory, is, let's say, you take a mathematical result, you just take the statement and you use it. Or you want to do a simulation evaluation and you take some mathematical result, you use it, and with that, but this is not the this is a problematic approach. The other approach is to understand. I remember I was talking with someone, and I was discussing the relationship between solving mathematical problems and approaching human relationships. And in both cases, the killer approach is to understand it. So the complexity of a mathematical problem is comparable to the complexity of human nature. And I think that I had seen that in a video again about Newton. So there was a psychiatrist, I think he was expressing the view that Newton had created empathy with mathematical problems. And I think it's the same mental circuitry. So I had been able to pinpoint more precise things, but I don't remember them now. But so you can empathize with a problem, but it's different because the problem does not empathize with you. There is some absolute, more or less, thing. But human nature is very much related to mathematical structure. We have to discover it, but it is. It's fine. So, as I said before, it's much more sophisticated than the mathematics we know. We will get there. However, so empathizing with problems and empathizing with your with the object of your relationship. it makes sense. So, it is interesting that Newton, a high school teacher, told me that he died a virgin. He was a deeply erotic person. I was at the Trinity Library at Cambridge trying to read some of his manuscripts. It was very interesting. I was reading his Latin texts and I couldn't understand. Because I think sophisticated Latin is like Greek. It's extremely influenced by Greek. But it was in Latin and I couldn't understand. And also, as you say, by the way, Newton spoke Greek and he has written text in Greek. And so I could feel his pain as he was going to bars in Cambridge in what he wrote as baroporia, which is a Greek word, I think. I don't know if bar is a Greek word. I'm not sure. Bara is a Greek word. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe it's not. But poria is like, you can only look it up. So his barporia means bar hopping. He was doing bar hopping in Cambridge and I was reading what he was writing in Latin. I could understand and I could also feel his pain that he couldn't communicate with the people. He couldn't connect. But he had a very deep, strong desire to do that. So he empathized with problems and he was very successful. So anyway, the important point here is understanding. Of course, you should have functional relationship with your order results, and Sometimes it makes sense to have functional relationship with your girlfriend. However, so the big question is, so if you solve a problem, what is next? The problem itself has many facets, and a person can change, the brain can expand or change, like different viewpoints, etc. So it's not an issue, but you should be respectful of this relationship. So I'm not really worried about this. I should legitimately be worried, but I don't think I should be too worried about this. And yeah, so understanding is a very sophisticated process.
Because I plan to do also more general entries, I will mark the problem solving videos with a red heart, so they would be the red heart entries.